It was back in 2017 that we saw the launch of the Hyundai Creta, and since then it's done exceptionally well. In 2020, we saw the second generation arrive, and this year it's had a facelift. But this year also saw the launch of the Grand Creta. So what's the difference, I hear you ask? Well, that's what I'm here for. So let's delve in. So I'm currently driving the updated Creta, and it competes with the likes of the Toyota Corolla Cross, the Kia Seltos, etc., which are all great family cars. They've got sort of enough rear legroom, and the boots are generally big enough for you to fit quite a bunch of stuff in it. But what if the Creta is just a little too small for your family?
Enter the Grand Creta. This is a 7-seat version of the much-loved Creta. So it's 200 millimeters longer and a little taller. The wheelbase is 150 millimeters longer as well. This means that there is enough space to fit 7 passengers in it and a teeny bit of luggage space, 180 liters that is. But with the second and third row down, you'll get a whopping 1,670 liters of boot space. This should give you an idea of how big it is inside. Most of us, however, would probably just have the second row up and the third row down, or just use the third row for really small children. So basically what the Grand Creta really offers over the Creta is a much bigger boot.
The interior is quite different in the sense that the Grand Creta feels ever so slightly more premium than the Creta. And speaking of premium, the Creta only comes in a premium level and executive level, whereas the Grand Creta comes in executive and elite.
If we look at the top spec of both models, both have keyless entry, a wireless phone charger, a rear view camera with parking sensors, and cruise control, among other features. The Grand Creta, however, adds a push button start, a panoramic sunroof, front parking sensors, and ventilated seats. Speaking of which, the seats aren't heated, only ventilated. But I think that will suffice if you consider our rather warm summers here in South Africa.
When it comes to the engines, the Creta no longer has a turbo petrol or turbo diesel in this updated model. You only get a 1.5 litre naturally aspirated engine. It comes mated to either a 6-speed manual or Hyundai's version of a CVT, so basically an automatic, if you will. But the Grand Creta comes with either a 1.5 litre turbo diesel or a 2 litre naturally aspirated engine, also mated to either a manual or Hyundai's version of a CVT. As you can tell, I am off-road a bit now, and that's one thing that the Creta is really great at. The ground clearance makes it really easy to traverse sort of uneven terrain, which I'm on now.
When it comes to pricing, things can get rather confusing because there is a price overlap between the Creta and the Grand Creta. But remember, it will be the standard features that will make all the difference. For example, the top of the range Creta costs around 20,000 Rand more than the bottom of the range Grand Creta. But if you want all the spec that is on offer in the top of the range model, the Grand Creta comes in at almost 100,000 Rand more than the Creta. So you'll need to decide whether it's the space and performance you want or more features for less.
The Grand Creta doesn't really have many rivals. It's sort of in a league of its own because most 7-seaters are either far more expensive or far cheaper than the Grand Creta. You could look at something like the Chery Tiggo 8 Pro, but for the same sort of price, you're getting a lot more car for your money.
However, if your heart is set on a Creta but with more space, more oomph, and a few more features, then hop onto Gumtree to find the perfect deal on the Grand Creta.